DFS fans, welcome to the Zurich Classic. I gotta be honest with you guys, I did not think I would be here sitting and doing a video, any video, let alone this video, for this week, as DraftKings the last couple of years, well, they've decided not to give us contests for the Zurich Classic because it's a team event. DraftKings hasn't figured out the scoring or the record we're keeping. Who knows? But this year, they've got it all figured out, and we're heading down to the Bayou in New Orleans for the week for the Zurich Classic. Let's learn a little bit about this course and player preview, as this is one of my five PGA DFS short form videos where I go over all the information you need to make successful lineups for the upcoming week. And this one obviously going to be a little weird given the fact that it is a team event. We've only had one other instance, where we've been able to have a team event on DraftKings. Now, this time, obviously, it being just single partners, the entire tournament will be a little bit different. Hopefully, we don't have prices out yet. Hopefully, DraftKings does price all of the partners as the same price, because if not, that could make things a little bit messy. TPC at Louisiana, not TPC Louisiana. TPC at Louisiana is our host here this week. Par 72, 7,500 yards for this golf course. Maybe a little bit shy, 7,500 yards. Eerily similar to its sister golf course there in Jacksonville, Point of Vitro, TPC Sawgrass. Of course, this is a Peter Dye design. Opened in 2004, and I feel like it did open to host a PGA Tour event here in the area. There has been a tournament in the area for some time now, close to 100 years, something around there. But it's been at this golf course since 2004, except for when Hurricane Katrina came in and did a ton of damage to the golf course. The golf course is right along the Bayou and Riverbend, so not surprised to see it be affected by Katrina so many years ago. But that was the only time that the tournament hasn't been held here since 2004. Your average green size here, that's going to be 5,500 square feet. The driving accuracy in greens and regulation, while we don't have that information because they don't keep it for team play, you can expect driving accuracy to be somewhere along the lines of TPC Sawgrass, 60 to 65%, with greens and regulation somewhere around the same thing. Again, it plays very similar to that course. In the field this week, there are 160 players. That's 82-man teams. Four of the world's top 10 are here to compete, and 20 of the world's top 50. So plenty of people wanting to come play in a fun team event. Now, there will be no OWGR points, so maybe a little bit different in that regard. Maybe some people don't want to come play that normally would, that are looking for those OWGR points and the like. So let's talk about a couple of the players. Of course, the highest ranked player in this week's field is John Rahm. And now we're going to go into our highest salary guesses. Before I tell you about a couple of players that are here this week on merit and by their partner. And this is the cool thing, is any PGA Tour pro that was eligible for this week's field was allowed to pick their own partner, regardless of status that that partner may have on PGA Tour or not PGA Tour. Perfect example of that is Justin Suh. He's going to be playing with Doug Gim here this week. No sponsor exemption needed in that regard, or I should say an automatic sponsor exemption was given. Akshay Bhatia, he's also going to be in the field this week. He's going to be playing along with Scott Piercy. A couple of other names like that. We got Rocco Mediate playing again. Again, a couple of other players that are playing based off of that qualification where a full-time PGA Tour member asked them to be their partner. Okay. Let's go ahead and give you my top salary guesses here for the week. And again, I'm doing this at 8:15 on Monday, so these are all guesses. If you come out and see that by the time you see this video, if you see that salaries are in fact out, let's check and see how good I did. So we're going to go with John Rahm and Ryan Palmer. I'm going to group them as priced the same. I really hope DraftKings does the same when they do put their salaries out. So, okay, Ryan Palmer, John Rahm, they're going to lead at 11,000. Patrick Cantlay and Xander Schauffele have got coming in at 10,800. Mark Leishman and Cam Smith coming in at 10,400. Matt Wolf and Colin Morikawa not too far behind them at 10,300. Then you got Bubba Watson and Scottie Scheffler. Solid team there, 9,800. And then to round it out, Ty Hatton and Danny Willett I got coming in at 9,700. Again, there are 82-man teams here this week. A great way to find out what the strength of those teams are, head on on over to one of the newest premium tools here at Osmo.com, and for you this week, it is the unofficial World Golf Rankings. That is what Alex Baker and I put our heads together and came up with a little bit better of a ranking system than the official World Golf Ranking. So be sure to check that out and get a couple of tidbits on what some of the stronger teams may be here this week. So until next time, everybody, I've got four more videos coming out. Of course, my top five bets, my top five sleepers, my top five fades, and of course, my top five values, all for the Zurich Classic here this week at TPC at Louisiana. So until next time, everybody, make sure you like and subscribe, especially subscribe. Those videos come out at all different times. You want to get notified when they are live. And of course, be sure to check out our live shows this week. Got a couple on Monday, Tuesday, and then of course the live before lock on Wednesday. So until next time, everybody, good luck at the Zurich Classic. We'll see you next week for the Valspar, my home event. Cheers, everybody.